In today's video on Steel Conduit, we're looking to apply the skills we've already acquired in other videos in this playlist. I will leave a link to that in the description below. And in that playlist, Jake did a double set to required measurement and a 90 degree bend. And we're gonna put those two together in one piece of conduit. So that's quite a hard skill to get to an exact measurement. So we've mimicked it here, haven't we? We've got a socket box some distance off the wall, so that will be a big double set. We come to a fixed point here where we'll have to have a 90 degree bend. And then obviously we'll cut back to the required length, thread, and put a coupler on to finish off that conduit. We've shown all of those skills individually, and that's what's in the playlist, but we're gonna bring them all together.
That's right. So the first thing we're gonna do is tackle our set. We need to know the depth of that set. Let's take a look and measure that now. So you might struggle to see that, but we are 76 mil to the back of our set, which meets up with the back of this knockout here.
So any other considerations? Obviously we're gonna need to fasten it to the wall.
That's right, so we're gonna be fixing this conduit to the wall using distance saddles. We need to take the depth of that saddle into account. Again, you might struggle to see this, but the depth of these distance saddles is 6 millimeters.
So the double set itself, if we did one in a previous video at 50 mil set, this one's gonna be 70, is that right?
This one's gonna be 70 millimeters once we take off the depth of the saddle, yeah. So I've got my length of conduit here. Because we're working from a fixed measurement, I'm going to put my coupler on first. I'm going to make sure that's on firm but not super tight, and that will give me room for fine adjustment should I need it later. Yeah. So now I'm going to go ahead and measure from the end of the conduit to our first bend, and that's going to be 100 millimeters. Again, that's not extremely crucial. So I mark the conduit at 100 millimeters. I can now go ahead and insert this into the conduit bender, lifting up the handle under the stop. I'm going to place our mark there at the edge of the former.
Can you just remind me how many degrees that you'll look to pull this first bend? It's not 45, is it?
No, so I'm going to aim for around 30 degrees. Yep, so I'm happy with that. Now, take this out of the conduit bender. And remember, the measurement we're looking for in this set is 70 millimeters. So I'm gonna place this on the table and mark that.
So we're looking for this to be 70 mil. So we've shown one previously doing 50. Again, you're doing it in a couple of positions just to check that we're parallel with the surface. And then same technique, just gonna mark it.
And then again, I'm going to strike a line underneath. So I've got my line.
That's the one that's going to go against the former, yeah?
Yep. So again, insert this back into the conduit bender, flipping this 180 degrees. And as we explained in a previous video, Gary, I need that line to be running along with this former here, following that.
So it just needs to go in a fraction further.
That's right, yeah.
So you've got that line following the former just there.
Yeah, I'm happy with that.
And again, it's crucial that we get it pointing in the right direction.
I want to make sure this is running straight. And I'm happy with that, so I'm ready to bend now.
So now you're going to put these two parallel to each other, yeah?
That's right, yeah. So again, I'd rather underbend it than overbend it. I'm gonna step back, take another look. That looks somewhere close, so I'm gonna remove that now. See how that is.
And again, it's crucial we set the first part of the bend correct and not the second part. So we're gonna set this again to what we think it would have been, which is 70. And then we look down, don't we, to see whether we've got to put any more bend into it.
So, 70 there. Yep, so we can see that's running out, so we need a little bit more in that, Gary.
Ah, yeah, in relationship to the table, you've just got to put a tiny bit more. It's not a lot, though, is it?
No, so again, just fine adjustment there. Insert that back into the conduit bender.
It should sit nicely into the position which you need it now, shouldn't it? You'll know when it's effectively in the right place. And you just add a little bit more to it.
Again, just a touch.
So again, setting the first one in the correct position, not the second one. You're going to set that one to 70 mil again.
Yep.
Okay, that's set. And then we look down to see whether we're running. Well, it looks pretty good actually,
yep,
is it?
Looks good to me.
So you're happy with that? The set now is at 70 mil.
I'm happy with that, yeah.
But by adding the saddle, in this case a distance saddle, you'll add the 6 mil that you needed, yeah?
That's right, so that'll be perfect for the measurement of 76 mil off the wall.
Okay, so I take it we've got to do another measurement now from the end of the conduit to the back of the bend. We've got to take that distance saddle into account again?
That's correct, so we'll be taking the measurement, as you say, from this end where it meets the socket to the back of the bend. So we're going to go ahead now and take our measurement from our socket to the back of our bend, which is 656 millimetres. As we said earlier, we need to minus the depth of the distance saddle off that measurement, which is 6 millimetres.
So what's your good maths telling you the measurement is? So
that's going to give us a measurement of 650 millimetres.
So that's going to be our back of the bend measurement that we've seen in a previous video, but we've now got to take into consideration that set and obviously locating it correctly in the conduit bending machine.
So I'm going to now go ahead and take our measurement from the edge of the conduit to the back of our bend.
So this was the measurement you did from the side of the socket box, and you said it was going to be 650 millimetres?
That's right, yeah.
So take your time to get it right. So that will be our back of the bend measurement?
That's right, yeah.
Is there any top tips now? Because obviously I could bend this in all kinds of ways where I'm not going to run parallel with the double set in the right position.
Yep, so we'll take this over and visualise this, which way we're going to bend this. So that's the way our set's going to be. The bend needs to be coming towards us. So I'm just going to go ahead and place a mark on the side there. Now I know if that's in the conduit bender and the line is facing up, that's going to be going the wrong way. The bend will be going away from us. I want that line to be facing to the ground.
Ah, so that line or face to the ground, you get your set in the correct position. And obviously when you bring it back over and rotate it round, it will fit the job. I like that. That's right, a good little tip.
So insert this back into the conduit bender.
So this is the bit I would suggest that students need to really think before they do any more bending. Right, so the first one is that mark that we're going to bring in our conduit and look at getting it squared off to the former, is that right?
That's right, yeah. So I'm going to insert my scrap conduit into the former. Use my set square to make sure that is 90 degrees. And that line wants to be running down in between my set square and scrap conduit.
So that's parallel with the line, I think maybe a fraction further in, is
yeah.
it? Yeah. Okay, so those two now marry up, and that should be 650. From the end of the conduit to the back of the bend. Obviously you wouldn't want it to move at this stage. So you're going to put some pressure on
yep.
it. Yeah, and then we're going to bend that one. Now, you said about this other line. Can I see it on the top?
Can't see it on the top.
So it must be on the bottom, and now obviously it's crucial that we line these up correctly, do you agree?
That's right, so I need to ensure this is running straight, which it is, so I'm ready to bend.
Okay, a lot of top tips there. Take your time being the most important one.
So I'm going to step back and take a look again. You can see that needs quite a bit more. Step back, take another look. Just a touch more. I'll take that and have a look.
So bringing it into a fixed line again like we did before. And then I'm going to square it off against the surface, yeah?
Yeah, needs quite a bit more in that, Gary.
And what we always said was probably best to be underbent, so a little bit more bend in there. Okay.
Take another look at that. Yep, I'm really happy with that. So I'm going to go ahead, bring this conduit in and offer it up just to confirm it's correct.
Moment of truth. So we're sitting against the wall there, and if I follow it round Ah, you're short, mate. You're short.
A touch short, Gary, but you're forgetting the 6mm distance that we took off for the distance saddles.
Okay, because that's against the wall. We're going to bring it out 6mm. That's going to be perfect, isn't it?
Yeah.
So now you've got to make another cut, haven't you? Because obviously we're now going to need to cut it to thread it to come into this box.
Yep, so we're going to measure from this surface. We've already got our coupler in here. So I'm not going to measure right up to the socket. I'm going to measure up to half of the coupler.
Oh, so you're going to be brave?
Going to be brave, going to do it first time.
So that's halfway through the coupler you're going to take a measurement. Now, I've known students to actually just cut the conduit here where the box is and start threading, coupler on, coupler off, coupler on. So that's more of a, you know, a safety net. But you're going to go half a coupler in, yeah?
Yep, that's right. So half that coupler, we are at 384mm.
Okay.
And again, we've got to take into account for the distance saddle on this side, which is at -6mm.
So what's the measurement now you're going to cut it out?
378mm.
And then we're going to cut it, thread it, put on the coupler, and then it should fit perfectly between the two points.
Yeah. So I'm now going to go ahead and mark my measurement from the back of the bend at 378mm, as we said.
So we're onto the back of the bend there using the set square. Again, it's worth taking your time, isn't it, just to get this right, because you're going for bang on measurement.
That's right, yeah. So 378.
So that's going to be cut there. You're going to put a number of threads on it. You're going to wind on your coupler. And in a one-er, you think you're going to get it between those two fixed points.
Yep.
Good luck, Jake.
Take it over, cut and thread it.
So we've shown this in the previous video presentation, so if you haven't checked this one out and you just want to learn the technique of how to do the perfect thread, then obviously check out that video. We're just going to run through this one. We're not going to over-elaborate what you're doing on this one.
Again, as you say, Gary, we've done a video on this before. I'm just going to apply forward pressure just to get this started. And that's on there now. So I can begin threading now. A couple of turns back just to clear that out. And I've got a couple of threads poking through, so I'm happy with that.
Important now we ream it, isn't it, and clean it up?
Yep. So remove all that excess compound. I'm going to use a round file this time.
Just a case now putting the coupler on, and we'll see if it's the right dimensions.
And again, I'm going to make sure this is firm but not super tight.
So can you undo that with your hands will be the trick. If you can undo that with your hands, it probably isn't quite tight. No, that'll pass an assessor.
Let's take it over, moment of truth. Let's find out. I'm just going to loosely put this machine first.
It gives you something to lever off then, doesn't it? Yep. Obviously with two fixed points. So loosely put the bush in this end. At this stage, I'd rather be a little long than a little short. Wow.
There we go. Oh, beautiful.
So you just push that back into those two saddles. That pushes loosely in there and you're in. So if we were a fraction long, it wouldn't be a problem, would it? We're just a case of taking couplers off, adding a thread, tightening up, and reintroducing it into the position. So that is incredible. Hopefully you were as impressed as I was with Jake's skills in order to put the double set and a bend into given dimensions and get it in there first time. We would suggest that there could be some adjustment, couldn't there? Adding threads, doing couplers a little bit tighter, etc., in order to get it to fit. So there'll be more videos coming into this playlist on Steel Conduit. We want your feedback. What would you like to see Jake do? Please leave those comments below. And as always, he'll get back to all of them.